Hey guys, plan is to sleep up there, fly down in the morning because I needed a break from my daily life. It's beautiful. I think there's barely not enough snow to nicely get up there without any problems. Timing is good as well. And I'm alone, which I really appreciate because I needed some time off. It's incredible, isn't it? All right, let's keep going. What a timing! I'm almost at the top. Some clouds are moving in. These are really big cumulus, but I'm gonna stay up here nonetheless. I'm really lucky I'm in this hole. And it should stay that way. Well, I better hurry to the top so I have some nice lights to set up camp. So, I'm gonna see you there. Wow, look at this. Isn't it beautiful? Seems like I came just in time. Oh, I'm really done for the day. The lights in the villages are slowly turning on as it's getting dark. Beautiful. Let's set up some camp. Sun went almost down. The villages are glowing, and I got my setup. So it's time to sleep now. Well, not sleep yet. I still got snacks and thoughts about my life that I have to work through. And after that, I can sleep nicely. All right, I'm really excited to get into my cozy sleeping bag. Oh, it's gonna be so warm. All right, see you there. It's getting dark now. I got my sausage and my bread. And it is so freaking calm and silent. The tracks up here were really old, so people haven't been up on this mountain for a few days, which means that I have it all to myself in every way possible. And I feel really honored. You have to see this again. It is incredible. Wow. And I'm so warm. I grabbed the warmest sleeping bag I have because I definitely didn't want to freeze up here. So with this one, it is plenty warm and I'm cozier than I would be at home. I'm excited for this meal. All right, I ate my food, I brushed my teeth. Slowly the stars are coming out. The moon is a bit more than half glowing today. And it's beautiful. It's an incredible mood. There are a few clouds down there, right above it. You got a nice view. And it is so calm. Infinite space for thoughts. You know, normally I don't do these kind of videos, this, let's call it vlogging on a mountain. but I really enjoy watching it. So that's why today I grabbed my GoPro and I thought, hey, I'm gonna film it. You know, on this YouTube channel, normally I just upload the really extreme stuff of paragliding, skiing, whatever it is I'm doing with the boys, and it's really incredible, but it's these peak these peak adrenaline moments, and it is an incredible memory. I really, oh my, me and friends of mine, oftentimes we sit down and we watch these videos and it makes us so damn happy because we get to relive that moment. And that's one of the main reasons why I'm uploading the videos here on this channel. You know, most of my days I spend at home, so I'm sitting either on my PC, editing, designing, working on projects, these kind of things, or I am in my woodwork shop, crafting stuff, building stuff, for clients, for myself, whatever. But yeah, after a while, you feel really stuck, and I wish I could live in a world where I'm just productive, day in and out. I'm in my woodwork shop, making stuff, making incredible stuff, not stopping. That would be amazing, but I don't think that's how humans work. From everything I've witnessed in my life, I don't think there's anybody that can do that. So it is what it is. We can only do the best. We can only make the best of it, right? So for me, I need the balance. I need to go up here to the mountain, and then I have a bit of space to myself, and I'm untouchable. You know, there's so many things back home that really stress you. They haunt you. It can be so nice to escape up here. Adult life is damn busy, and I don't even have kids yet. Oh my. But you know what it is. I mean, there's so many things, especially if you live in a city and you want a lot in your life, right? Your life is damn complicated, and I am living that way right now. So I own a lot. I have to take care of a lot. I have a lot of responsibilities. It can feel really overwhelming at times, right? So I go up here, no one can reach me, no one can touch me. This is my space. And I can think about whatever I want. It's incredible. It's so incredible. But I have to say, sometimes I am really, really struggling to get out. I have days where I really should go to the mountains, and I have time, it would make sense, but I can't do it. I'm inside, and you know when you feel unproductive, you're mad at yourself, and then you tell yourself, hey, you have to be productive, don't go to the mountains right now. Feels like a circle. Feels like you're running in a circle at that point. I used to struggle with it more. It's getting better because I'm really realizing that I go to the mountains, I come back, I'm productive. It just works. I can't be focused on something day in and out, day and night, every day. At some point, there's a limit. It works nicely for a time, and I enjoy locking myself in, but at some point there's a limit. I know, I've been blabbing a lot. Lots of thoughts, but I'm enjoying this because I like to think that we all are in the same boat. We all live different lives, we get raised different, but at the end of the day, I think fundamentally we struggle with the same things. Every person I see, they formulate their problems in their own way, but the root always seems the same. Whoa, there was a shooting star. Oh my. That was a tiny one, but a cute one. Oh my, and all the stars are slowly coming out. Oh my. This is incredible. Well, since I'm already talking, I've just got to embrace it and I'll keep talking. The cool thing is this is YouTube, right? If you don't like it, skip it and watch some cat videos. Or skip it and watch some guy backflip on his skis on a 2,000 feet cliff. Maybe this video is really cool for people to watch after I'm gone. They could get an idea of who I was. I'd like to think that it could be very interesting to people. Oh, once I died. So, if you're watching, this is me. And I am absolutely living the life. Really, I'm happy out of the bottom of my heart. I'm really thankful for all the incredible things in my life. Sometimes life feels overwhelming. Sometimes I escape to the mountains like I do right now, trying to mitigate that. Sometimes I take my paraglider and I lift off in an attempt to escape even further. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, but yeah, at the end of the day, I'm managing, right? I managed so far, and I'm really giving it my best. I cannot complain. I really can't. I have incredible people in my life. It's absurd. I have the sweetest, nicest, most awesome people around me that I could even ask for. They're really cool people. So if you're one of them, really, I appreciate you. So who am I? Let me try to describe it. I would say my two biggest passions probably define me the most, because most of my choices in life I make based on these two passions. So it is, for one, the making and designing stuff. I'm not sure how much my family influenced me, because my dad is quite a legendary carpenter. My mom, a really passionate architect. So even when I was little, my siblings pushed me to be creative, crafty. I always had to help my dad in the workshop and on and with clients. So maybe I just got good at it, and then I started enjoying it, and then I kept going with it. I got better, and then it became a big passion. I don't know. That's one theory I have. But either way, right now, till this day, it always was the thing that always drove me and gave me a lot of motivation. It was really making stuff made me damn satisfied, and it gives me a purpose in life, because oh my, there's so much you could pick as a purpose in life, but for me, it's really satisfying when I can share all the things I learn about when I craft stuff, or I can design stuff that other people can make, especially in this time of our population. It's easier than ever. It's really incredible, right? So that feels nice. That feels satisfying. To each their own, right? And this is just my way, but that's the best way I can describe it, why I like it. So I'll stick at it and I give it my best, and you guys can really expect some cool designs coming from me. The second thing is paragliding. Honestly, I don't know if it's gonna stay like that, but 2 years ago, roughly, I started paragliding, and it was unlike every sport I did before, because before that, sport to me was really just something I did because I wanted to stay active, fit. I wanted to hang out with my friends, so we did sporty stuff. That was the reason. It felt good, I could push myself, these kind of things. And but I knew that I could never be happy just doing sport. It was really I hiked up on a mountain and I told myself, okay, you're doing sport now, so you're gonna be more fit after this hike, so it's good, approved. I really, really always needed to find reasons why I get to do some sport. And with paragliding, it just feels different because for the first time with the paragliding, I can be in the air and I don't feel guilty. So I'm up in the air and I'm just enjoying. That's why I share these moments so much as well, because they are just incredible. They feel incredible and I want to share them. So these are my two big passions, and I think that's absolutely enough to know about me. And if you watch this and I'm dead, oh my, I'm really wondering how old I got, because I have no idea. Sure, I don't plan on dying, and I'm enjoying life. I'm gonna keep going, 100%, but you never know, right? Life is fragile. We humans, oh my, look at us. We're so complicated and so damn fragile. So I'm incredibly thankful that I still get to have awesome days, and I always want to be grateful that I get to live another day. So I have no idea how long I'm gonna live. So much crazy stuff to come. The future must be wild. All right, I think this is enough of my thoughts. I'm gonna try to sleep. Well, first I gotta do my Duolingo lesson because I don't want the bird to fly up here and beat me up. So I'm gonna do that and then sleep. Watch the stars, wake up and see what the sun is saying. Sleep tight, guys. It's beautiful, and the fog in the valley now finally moved away towards the lake, and the landing spot is perfectly clear, so I could go down, enjoy some of the sunlight from the early morning and continue my day. Thank you. in the car, and now I'm heading to a different mountain, half an hour away. Got to meet a friend there because thermals today should be a bit better, so maybe I could stay up in the air a bit. Anyway, I'm pretty sure it's going to be loads of fun, and I can't wait to meet the friend. All right, see you there. Taking a walk on the wild side, something in the way she moves, candle in the wind and it's blowing everywhere we go. All these girls got something going on. Met in a club, her name was Lola, champagne tasting Coca-Cola in the hands of my love, and oh, my love does it good. All us boys need something that they got. This one's for Elise. No jeans, Patty Boy. I dropped off a friend and I'm almost back home. That was really nice. I have to say, today later in the day I tried out to fly a bit more thermally. It's on my to-do list. I want to do it this spring, try it out more. But oh my, really, like, today made me realize once again that my heart really lies with hike and flies and soaring, speed flying, these kind of things. I just like it.